continue to stay connected to our live video, but we got it working and pray for the Lord. And well, going back, well, we were going into Matthew chapter 1 when the angel Gabriel appeared to Mary. When the angel said that you're going to have a newborn son, Jesus, so he said his name should be Emmanuel, that God is with us. So God chosen Mary to put the newborn son in Jesus to go carry out the gospel, because when Jesus is the one, is the way, the truth, and the life as well. If you can read Mark, Mark chapter 16, verse 20.
And they went out and preached everywhere, the Lord working with them and confirming the word through the accompanying signs. Amen.
Amen. And read Hebrews chapter 13, verse 8.
Hebrews chapter 13, verse 8. Yes. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever.
Amen. You know, when I was thinking about in the scripture that when the miracle of Jesus did in the past, you know, you go to the Old Testament, you see account that how Jesus, you know, did so many, you know, miracles. And well, with one of the stories, you know, I love going to the beach. I like going to the beach, and one time when I went with, you know, two of my co-workers, well, the Godfrey and the Donnie, we were out fishing. And for the first time, I was in a boat, and we're going into the water, to the out bay of the ocean. Man, like in my mind, man, wow, man, look at all this water, you know, surrounding the whole area, and we're just fishing. And I'm like, man, I feel so safe being in that boat. And the reason why I mentioned the ocean, you know, how the ocean is just so mysterious, it's just so, you know, wonderful, you know, that our mind can comprehend the how deep the water is as well. And there's a story here I want to talk about, one about Moses. When Moses delivered the Israelites out of Egypt, when they were walking into the desert, and they were chased by Pharaoh, by horses and chariots. And when it got to the point on Moses, when all the Israelites, when they're saying, why did you rescue us? We want to stay back in Egypt. But yet when what happened in the story in Exodus chapter 14, and I want to, if you can read Exodus chapter 14, verse 13 to 14.
And Moses said to the people, "Do not be afraid. Stand still and see the salvation of the Lord, which he will accomplish for you today. For the Egyptians whom you see today, you shall see again no more forever. The Lord will fight for you, and you shall hold your peace."
Because imagine this for a moment, you know, if you're the kind of person that likes to the beach, if you're down south by your island, imagine the water just divide. You know, I mean, you see the whole, you know, open, you know, road. Because you're hearing that Priscilla said in Exodus chapter 14, verse 13 to 14, there are three statements that were underlined. There's fear. Now, fear, everybody can go through fear. Everyone can go through, you know, a moment of, you know, being discouraged, worrying, you know, about your grades or financial. But the Bible says that God did not give you the spirit of fear, but power, love, and a sound mind. Because of him, the Bible says in Romans 8:31, if God is for you, who will be against you? And in Romans 8:37, that all these things were more than comfort for him that loves us. Because the opposite of, the opposite of fear is faith. In your own journey, you're going to have so many challenges. You're going to have a moment that, you know, you can't, you know, comprehend. Now, imagine the story when you see Moses going to leave Israelites into the ocean. They're getting chased by Pharaoh. They're getting chased with horses and chariots. And when Pharaoh said, "We got you, there's no way you can go." Well, when Moses in the story in Exodus chapter 14, he put up the stack. And what happened, God listen and God invited the ocean. Maybe you have a moment in your life that God needs to open that ocean in your life. Maybe that you're tired, you know, of the same routine. You're tired, you know, always get negative reports. You always get, you know, feeling, you know, like less. You're feeling that, you know, you can't, you know, the world have, you know, overwhelmed you. You know, you just feel tired. You know, you just feel, you know, weak. But always remember that God will give you spirit of fear, the power of love and a sound mind. And what I learned in my journey, I want to teach you something. And through the Colossians chapter 3, that we set our mind above. If you set your mind above, which is Jesus, if you surrender yourself to Him, and knowing that this world is temporary, this world is going to fade away, but God's word will remain, because if you set your mind above to the heaven, if you set your mind to Jesus, knowing that I want to teach you something that I learned in my own journey that, you know, and persistently, when people that when I feel discouraged, negative, they feel trapped, they feel bonded, and they feel like, you know, they have nowhere out because it's all about the mindset. Where are you putting your mind? Where are you putting your heart? Because when if you set your mind in the Word, if you set your mind upon Jesus, then Jesus will make a way for you. And then the one thing I like, what Priscilla said, is to stand firm. Stand firm. Stand in the Word. Stand in the gap. Because I can imagine when Moses, when he was leading the Israelites, and Moses was hoping for a miracle. Moses was believing for a miracle. What happened when Moses was there, when there was massive ocean water, and what happened, all the Israelites, they were just going to give up. They were going to get defeated. They're going to let the Pharaoh and all the Israelites to get them. What happened, young people? There was a miracle. You know, through the journey in my walk with the Lord, I didn't know, you know, all the miracles. I didn't know that when I was 17 years old, I went, what? God departed the Red Sea? How did that happen? Because God is the Alpha and Omega. He is the beginning and He is the end. He is the creator. He flung the stars. He created the mountains. He created everything. Because of Him, there's a miracle. And maybe in that season right now, you're like Moses. Maybe, you know, you're trapped right now. The enemy wants to get you. But I have good news for you. The Bible says in James that when we say, well, Jesus, the enemy will tremble. But what happened if people, you know, be firm? You know, what I learned in my journey, when I feel discouraged, when I feel defeated, man, I just pray Jesus through the moment in my defeat. Jesus wants to be with you every step of the way. Even though there's a moment that, you know, you feel like, you know, just weak, you feel like, you know, you're tired, and maybe you feel depressed, and yet Jesus is the only one that's close to the broken heart and crushing spirit. That's why we need to stand firm. The Bible says in Psalms 119, 105, that God's word is the lamp to my feet and the light to my path. And also, and the last one is be still. Be still. And I can imagine when Moses, in a moment that he was praying, a moment that he was hoping for a miracle, he was being still. He was getting ready, you know, just to rely on Him, on Jesus. Now, imagine that, you know, we're standing with Moses. Imagine we were delivered from out of Egypt. Now, did you know, as followers of Jesus, we no longer a slave of sin. I like a song last week. I know Stephanie sent me a video that we are no longer a slave to sin. We're no longer, you know, captive. We're no longer bondage of sin. Because when God spoke to Moses to open the sea, and I believe, young people, you're here today that you need a ocean to open up for you. You need to know that you are no longer a slave, but you are free in Christ. The Bible says in Galatians 2:20 that I've been crucified by Christ. I no longer live, but Christ that live in me. Because he is, in Hebrew, what Priscilla said, 13 verse 8, that he is the same yesterday, today, and forever. And I believe that once you're set free, and I know if I talk to a lot of, you know, students, teenagers, when they go through depression, they go through a moment of defeat, they have so many anxieties, worries, they just feel hopeless, they just feel that unloved and not being accepted. And I talk to them, about a little bit about how, you know, you have strength in you that is so viable, that the strength that you have, because yes, you are going to go through moments in that season, but did you know that your story that God writes each day, the story of influence other people, where you are right now, is going to make you stronger. Now, I'm going to close with this. God gets the hardest battle to the strongest soldiers. And knowing that you are an overcomer, you have victory in Jesus. Amen. Do you receive that message with me today? You know, we never want to close this service without giving you an invitation of hope. Maybe you're in this life right now, you're trapped. Maybe you're hoping for a miracle, you're hoping for a breakthrough in your life, your finances, your family, your marriage, or your school, or you're hoping for a breakthrough, but knowing that, you know, God will put Moses. Just like when God was with Moses, God will be with you today, because he is the same. And I want to give you an invitation of hope for you to be set free, for you to accept Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior. And now let's go ahead and pray. I want you to repeat the prayer after me. Lord Jesus, I come to you. Jesus, come into my heart. Jesus, be the Lord of my life. Jesus, I surrender. I believe that my name is written in the Lamb Book of Life. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Well, God bless you, everyone. I hope you're blessed about part one, the I Need a Miracle. And I know that we're going to continue to with the message series this month, and I'm very excited what God is doing in our second year of life purpose. But we're going to continue to be faithful, and I want to consider the talking prayer.
Father God, I come before you with a humble heart, knowing that your plan will prevail. You're sovereign. God, I put everyone that is watching, that watched today this sermon, in your holy hands. Put our hearts, our minds, our life in your hands, Father God. Protect us, guard us, protect us against the evil one and against our own evil thoughts. Give us self-control, power, love. Give us that spirit that Jared said, that spirit of a sound mind, power, love, that comes from you. In your name, amen.
Amen. Well, God bless you for your next week, and thank you for tuning in. Take care.